comments once again to our newly confirmed graduates and completers.
Congratulations, life learners!
Now it's time for us to hear a message from our school president and founder. Join us in welcoming on stage, Brother Alvin Barcelona.
Thank you so much, Sir Angelo, Sir Ayo. And a blessed, glorious day to all of us here as we congratulate our newly proclaimed graduates from the elementary course and completers from the junior high school course. Can you clap our hands again for them? Batch 2024 on our second victory ceremonies. Yes, second. Pangalawa na, napakabilis ng panahon. Nakakadalawang taon na po tayo sa BACFAO. Pero dalawang taon pa lamang. Ibig sabihin, malayo pa at marami pang taon ng ating pagsasamahan. Dalawang taon pa lamang, pero umaani na tayo ng tagumpay. 2 years, yet we are already reaping achievements and success. And the best achievements that we have are right here with us. Our sons and daughters, our dear life learners. But may I give you a quick background, especially to those who have come to us for the first time or for the first year, that it is only the second year of BACFAO, but Barcelona Academy is already on its 14th year. In fact, we're preparing for our glorious 15th year this coming school year. But even before that, Power Kids Academy, from where Barcelona evolved from, has already been running for the past 30 years. Kaya 30 taon na po ang partnership na ito, kasabay ng Catholic Filipino Academy, na kahit manong Power Kids Academy pa lang tayo, ay magka-partner na sa pag-provide ng homeschooling. Kaya po ang inyong mga anak, your sons and daughters are in good and experienced hands. In fact, ako po, ngayon lang ako nakikita ng iba sa inyo, 40 years na po ako sa education. Kinikwenta nyo din dito. 3 years pa lang teacher na po ako, kaya 43 years old pa lang ako. Pero kidding aside, Barcelona Academy, Catholic Filipino Academy, have never stopped learning, improving, and asking ourselves, what else can we do? That's the BACFAO way that you've been hearing from our powerful speakers. Yan po yung theme natin ngayong taon eh. The BACFA way. It's simply asking ourselves, teachers, administrators, including your parents and our life learners, what more can we do? How can we love you more? How can we serve you more? How can we be better at what we do? In fact, this celebration is a testament, a showcase of that. Kaya pinaghahandaan po namin. Alam namin yung iba sa inyo, ngayon lang mapupunta dito. At baka ngayon lang mapupunta dito, baka hindi na makabalik for some reasons or makabalik after a year. That's why we ask ourselves, paano kaya yung pagpunta nila sulit? Lalong-lalo na sa inyong online life learners. Minsan na kaya pupunta sa inyong paaralan. At graduation, completion ninyo. Ang marami sa inyo, galing pa sa ibang-ibang sulok ng bansa. From the south, from the north, as far as Cabanatuan, probably to Gigarao, as Doc Montes was telling me a while ago, to the south, Cavite, we've had students from Bicol, and from Visayas and Mindanao. We had students who attended or joined the recognition or from Butuan and Iloilo. And we know that a good number of you come from the different parts of the world. Abay, kanina lang sa recognition, at sigurado ko ngayon, may lumipad pa galing Singapore, Malaysia, galing Dubai, Oman, Kuwait, at kung saan-saan pa. Kaya, I always say that BACFAO, we just don't do programs or events. We create experiences. We create memories that will last for a lifetime. Para sulit ang inyong pagpunta. At sinasabi namin, you are special. Lalo na sa araw na ito. Kaya minabuti namin sa procession pa lang, the second victory ceremonies, the president, founder of Catholic Filipino Academy, our dear friend, Brother Bo Sanchez.
A big hand for Brother Alvin Barcelona. So good. So good. If there's one thing I want to share with you, it's just one message and two words. May I? Can you tell somebody beside you, don't stop. Don't stop. Don't stop. That's it. Don't stop. People come up to me and they like asking me this question. In fact, when I get interviewed, whether on television, radio, magazines, they ask me the question, Brother Bo, what's your secret? Why do you succeed in this or that? Why have you written 70 plus books? Why have you founded many ministries, you know? And so I give them a few examples and I ask them, do you know how long CFA has been going on? And they say, how many? And they say, 18 years. You know, we started with 27 students and now we're 1,000 or over the past 18 years. And do you know how long our media ministry has been? And I say, do you know Kerygma magazine? It's still today alive and kicking. It's called Feast magazine. And I said, do you know how long? And when did we start? And they said, when? 1990. 1990? That's 24 years. And I said, yes. And do you know when we started Truly Rich Club? Something else that I do, financial advocacy, financial literacy. And I said, when did that start? Oh, 17, 18 years old. And how many, do you know when did we start Light of Jesus? The feast. And are there people who joined the feast or even attended once? Thank you so much. So I asked them, do you know when we started? They said, when? 1980. 44 years ago, that's when we started. It was in a small garage, our garage. There were 30 people. And today, we are in 30 countries. And so I said, there lies the secret of success. Hindi pa nila na-gets. They said, what's the secret? I said, don't stop. Don't stop. You start, and then you just don't stop. You tweak, you adjust, you change, but you do not stop. We failed so many times. Can I share with you that my very first book that I ever wrote was a failure? If today I would read it, my gosh, the grammar was horrible. The writing style, I'm so embarrassed. It's like I want to dig my head on the ground and hide like an ostrich and say, I did not write that book. No, I did not. You know, but I did. But you see, if I did not write that first book, I would not have written the next 70 best-selling books. And so, can you tap somebody in the arm and say, please fail. You have to fail, not in school, thank God. No, not in school. But you need to fail in your many, many attempts in doing what you believe is right. You see, before you do something great, you will have to do something bad. You will have to mess up. But that's okay. That's the only way to become better. Let me close. Let me close. My friend, do you want to succeed in life?
Yes.
Do you want to be very, very happy?
Yes.
Raise your hand if you want to be a great success. Wave at me. Everybody say, I want to be a great success. Let me share. I'm a semi-old man. I'm 58. Although I know I look younger. 57 and a half. If I look back at my life and I ask myself the question, what were the greatest achievements of my life? I shared this with many of you before. I will always remember the happiest moments of my life. They were not the times when I received awards from the President of the Republic of the Philippines in Malacañang. I did, but that's not my happiest moment. My happiest moment is not that time when I received the greatest award the Catholic Church can ever give a layperson, the Servium Award, given by the Cardinal. I received that, but that is not my greatest reward. Nakakatawa niyo ba, nagyayabang ako? Pero parang subtle lang. What's my greatest reward? My greatest award are those happiest moments. There was a time when I was very young, I was still single, and I lived with a bunch of orphans for 1 year. I lived in the same house, and every day I would have breakfast with them. And then I would tell them stories over lunch. And then by the afternoon, I would give them a Bible study. And then before they sleep, I would read a bedtime story for them. I did that for 1 whole year. And I'm telling you, as a semi-old man looking back at my life, that was one of the happiest moments of my life. When I was 13 years old, I remember I was going to church, walking on the road, and then I saw beside a church a family, father, mother, 2 children, lying down and sleeping on that road. This 13-year-old boy, I saw them and I said, kawawa naman sila. And then I felt God tell me, do something about it. If you really feel bad, if you really feel pity. I said, what will I do? I'm only 13. And I felt God tell me, do something. I saw that there was a bakery beside. I went and I bought a piece of bread. I went to them, sat down beside them, and they woke up. And I said, here's breakfast. The father and the mother, they took the bread. They broke it up. They woke up the kids. The two boys started playing with me. You know, the moment I sat there, the smell was horrific. It was so bad. Do you know how big my nose is? And I want you to know that I said, I'm dying here. I'm dying. The smell was horrible. They've not been taking a bath for I don't know how long. And I tried, you know, when I was talking to them, I was trying to breathe uncontaminated air from somewhere. Yeah? Oh, wonderful. Yeah. But no, I was dying. And then the kids, they started climbing on me. And they went over my shoulder and they disheveled my hair. And one boy was just staring at me. You know, it that moment, you know, if you ask me whether their lives were transformed, I don't know. I really don't, because that was the last time I saw them. But my life was changed. And that was the reason why, that moment when I was 13 years old, that was the reason why we built Anuin, our ministry for the abandoned elderly. After 28 years, it's still here. We pick up lolos and lolas from the streets. And that's the reason why there's grace to be born. And that's the reason why there's Jeremiah, a home for sexually abused children. And that's why there's Pag-asa ng Pamilya, a home, a place where we give scholarships for poor children. And that I can go on and on and on. And I can say to myself that all of these happened because I failed. I did fail. Serving this family as a 13-year-old boy, giving them a piece of bread and playing with their children. I don't think they got out of poverty. It was a failure. But maybe it was not a failure. because it changed my heart. And it gave me the direction for the rest of my life. Am I a great success?
Yeah.
It's your turn. Be the greatest success you can ever become. You do it by loving and by being a great blessing to other people. God bless you. Congratulations to leaders. Maraming salamat.